Hey friends, I'm Diane and welcome to my farmstead dream. Today I thought I would show you a super quick and easy way that you can start your tomatoes once you know you've started your seed and you're ready to transplant them into something bigger, and then you can put them outside and leave them there even if it's cold. So let me show you what I do. Take this tomato, for example. This is a super sweet hybrid, and I have two in my little cup here, and I need each one to have its own separate cup. So I'm going to take a cup, just a little dollar store cup. I write the name on the cup with Sharpie marker. And I'll show you why we can do this in just a minute. And we don't have to worry about it fading off the cup. So I'm just gonna put some soil about halfway up in my cup. And then I'm gonna take my little bitty and I'm just gonna pull one of these plants out. And I'm gonna sit him down in here. And then I'm just gonna drop some soil in around him. Tamp it down a little, and then I'm just going to make sure that this one is doing okay. I'm going to tamp the soil down around it. Now, when you're growing tomatoes, when you bury them, you want to bury them, you know, pretty far up the stalk, because that helps them to grow a stronger root system. I like using these clear cups because then I can see if they're getting root bound, and this one still has plenty of room to grow in this cup. So now I have my little tray full of my tomato starts. Love these trays. I use these trays for everything. I use these trays for potting. I use these trays to hold my plants. I use these trays on my grow light setup. They're like the best thing ever, and I got them from the Dollar Tree, and they just look, well, that's gonna give you too much sunlight there, but they're just these little trays, and they're a dollar at the dollar store, not the Dollar Tree, the Dollar General. So if you want some trays that you can use to help you in your endeavors, you can check out my Amazon store. I'll try and see if I can find some of these to link in my description box or put in my Amazon store, so it'll make it a little easier for you to get to them. So then what do with these? Normally we would put these back in the garage where my grow light setup is. I would put them under the grow lights, but I'm trying something different this year. We're going to see if it works. So I went and got some of these. Well, actually, I ordered these on Amazon, and they're in my Amazon store as well. So if you want to grab you some, you can just click on the link to my Amazon store and go get them. It'll make it quick and easy for you to grab some. But I got these tubs, and you want to make sure that they're clear tubs, and you definitely want to make sure that you have a clear lid. So I'm just going to add some water into the bottom of my tub. And you want a pretty good thick layer for when you first do your transplants, because you want them to be able to get plenty of water. So you're going to put the water in the bottom of your tub, and then we're just going to start adding our tomato plants in. And so, as you can see, you don't have to worry about the weather getting to them. You don't have to worry about, that's why you don't have to worry about the ink washing off, you know, like the Sharpie marker washing off of your cup, so you always know what the name is, because it's in this little tub and it's protected from the elements, so you won't have to worry about losing your information off your cup. Okay, now once you get your tub full, all you're gonna do is you're just gonna put the lid on. I'm going to go ahead and click the little handles so that the lid doesn't fly off. And then you can leave this outside. It's a little mini greenhouse. How cool is that? So you have a little mini greenhouse. this can stay outside. As long as you don't get, you know, if you don't have temperatures that are below freezing or what have you, you just want to watch your temperatures carefully. And if you are going to have, you know, a day or so where your temperatures are going to get below, you know, freezing mark, then you'll just bring them in. But these are little mini greenhouses, so you can leave them outside and you can stack them. I'll show you. So you just stack them up and you leave them outside and you let them do what they do. Then when you're ready to transplant or begin to acclimate your plants to the outdoor weather, you just come out each day and you unstack them. You take the lids off of them and you let them acclimate to the outdoor weather. Now you're going to do this over a week's time period. So like the first day, you'll want to put them somewhere, you know, kind of shady. This area right here is not shady, but this is not where they're going to stay. But you'll want to kind of, I mean, you don't want them to stay in the shade all day long, or you won't get as good of a greenhouse effect as you will if they're in the sun. However, you also want to make sure that they have plenty of water in them so they don't dry out. You know, you don't want them to dry out and die in the heat. But anyway, so you bring them out, take the lids off for like an hour, and then the next day a couple of hours, and then the next day you're going to do a few hours, and so on and so forth until they're acclimated to the outdoor elements, and then you can plant them out. So it's much easier to do it this way versus having to carry them in and out every day when you get ready to acclimate them. This way they're already out here, and like I say, you watch your weather closely. If it's going to be a freeze or anything, then you'll want to take them inside. But it's much easier to transport them inside in these tubs, you know, one time, versus having to bring them outside every day for a week. So anyway, I just think that it's a much easier process, and we're gonna wait and see how they do, and we're just gonna kind of test this theory and see if it works. So hopefully it does, and I will keep you updated. If you have any comments or questions, leave them in the comment box below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Ring that little bell for notification for new videos. And I guess I will just see you in the next video. Hope you have an amazing day. Big hugs.